the emotions of what he's saying about leaving a legacy for your kids, about he could have bought this building for $2 million, but he didn't, and now this building is worth what, $50 million, whatever he said on that.
Mm-hmm.
About
mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? These mm-hmm. things are things that us as a community, we don't do, and we're not taking advantage of. And if rap music is our CNN and our way of, and sadly, it's our way of getting information, if this dude is infusing information like, yo, stop making it rain and use this money towards something good, you know what I'm saying? As a message, it only makes sense for us to embrace and push this album, and maybe the music will make a change one day. You know what I'm saying? If maybe he set the bar so high that somebody else between him, Kendrick Lamar, J. Cole, and the rest of them are going to push the bar up now.
Okay, that's what now, I okay, now I understand what you're saying, but just like what the young man just said, what was his name?
That's
the DJ?
Dollars and Cents.
Dollars and Cents. Just like Dollars and Cents just said, yeah. Jay-Z so past his prime that all he's done now is offend all the young dudes. So all they're going to do is more. So what happened the day after Jay-Z put this out? Say, y'all putting money to your ear and all that. Migos get on there and say, well, this is all my change and my money and all this stuff. Like, it's like now he's just made it a more divide between the young and the old. The people who are our age, who are already socially conscious and trying to do something better, we already knew these things and been trying to do all these things. We've been trying to save up money and get out of debt and get some land and investments and flip houses and do all these things. Like, he's not helping the people that really need the help, because now he's past the listening point. He doesn't have the frequency to pick up the people who really need to hear this message. We needed to hear this message in the 90s when we started listening to his ass talking about ball till you fall and it's all right. And Big Pippin, spin the G's.
You might want to Google what the millennials are saying. The millennials nowadays don't really listen to the older people. They're on their own agenda. So it doesn't really, they don't care. It doesn't take Jay-Z to move the millennials. If you do the research on what you're talking about, how the millennials are, they want fast, you know, they want to get ahead. They do have social agendas, but they don't care. Now, here's the thing, and I'll let you guys go because I got to get out of here. But I go and I talk to people and I coach and I do this. I got people that when I talk to kids, my message has completely changed from 6 or 7 years ago. So, but I have people that be like, Reggie, you ain't right. You say this and that because it's different. And if you think that because Jay-Z came out, that's going to change these millennials or mingles and all these, that you're deceiving yourself, bro. These young people don't care. And Jay-Z saying what he's saying is not gonna, was never going to affect them in any way. They just don't care because they don't have the same appreciation. Just like my fraternity.
Okay, so who is this helping then? Who are these words and these poignant words, as Kysii says, that his wife thinks, these talking points, who is this for then? If it's not for the young people.
It doesn't matter. If you can affect one person, it could be somebody like my age. I appreciate what Jay-Z said. I'm 44 and 45, and I'm like, wow. If you have the ability to listen and potentially take in and change, that then you're good. Like, I'm 44. It affects me, and I'm like, that's cool for me.
That ain't me, Mo.
And if you, you know, so that's it. If you take one person, it's okay.
Well, I mean, that's your opinion, brother. I'm not here to stifle anyone's opinion. I can't change your opinion about it. This is just my opinion. I think it's a mediocre album, and I think he's being very political with this. It's like he went into a room with a bunch of conscious people. He's been looking at the Black Lives Matter movement. He says, what are all the things that conscious black people are interested in? This, you know what I equate this to? This is like the girl who's been wearing a perm all her life and tight-ass dressing, and she shows up the next day with braids and a goddamn dashiki and an African medallion, talking about, yeah, back to the motherland, brother. That's what I equate that to. I equate this to somebody putting the black medallion around their neck and saying, nah, oh, my brother, well, assalamu alaikum, would you like a bean pie? That's what I equate this to. This is a wolf in sheep clothing because that man been selling you a Marcy project, and I'm the biggest dope dealer in the world for all these years, and now all he did was put a kufi on and did the same shit he criticized Nas about. Just because a nigga wear a kufi don't mean that he bright.
One last question for you. Here's what I got a question for you. So if we go about, you say, my man that started the Crips, or the Crips of the Bloods, Tukey, was all about gangbanging, killing, this and that. He goes to prison, sir, and he wins a Pulitzer Prize for changing and saying that, you know, these kids, you know, we shouldn't do drive-by shootings, blah, blah, blah. So people can change, my man.
I'm not saying that, but just like that's you're giving my example. Did the guy who went to jail, did he change the day after he got locked up? The day after he got locked up, did he was now?
Hold up. What were y'all talking at the same time?
I was just saying, real quick, and I'll shut up. But people were saying that he was just doing that to get out of jail, to get his sentence reduced. Isn't that the same thing as what you're saying about Jay-Z?
Exactly what I'm saying. But that guy proved that he wasn't, because after he got out of jail, he continued to preach to the youth and get people together and work. Well, dead. That's what I'm saying. But he was trying. He didn't do it one day after he was killing everybody and stop doing it. And he didn't do it for one day just to make a change and get out of jail and then go back to cripping.
Well, they put him on death row and he got killed. But here's the thing is that it's one album. So I see what Jay-Z does after this, sir. And I agree with you. Let's just see. I get your point. I really do.
I already know what's going to happen. He's going to put that. But I appreciate your enthusiasm.
I appreciate you, too. Thanks, Chief. Man. Thanks for having me. Great
and, hey, man. And thanks for playing clean music, man. I'm down with you on that.
Yes, sir.
All right, Dallas. Yeah. All right, let's get into another one of these songs, man.
What? Oh, somebody said how Jay-Z passed his prime, he just went platinum. Who said that, James?
James, the big truck driver.
James, the truck driver? How he passed his prime?
His prime. He ain't never lost. He ain't fell off. I can't think of a time frame when he has ever fell off. So I don't think he ever went past his prime outside of his age. Magna Carta sold. The Watch the Throne sold. You know what I'm saying? It ain't like this is LL Cool J coming out. Or Run DMC trying to put out an album.
I mean, but he's built such a person. He's like an icon. It's like you already got, you know what I'm saying? You have the anticipation of people waiting for it and wanting it. So they're going to listen and buy it. So it's like just like a movie that comes out on Friday and they're like, oh, it's the biggest movie blockbuster. And then the next week, it's the number three movie. Let's see what it does next week after the gloss or the sheen of this turd that he shined and painted gold for you guys has worn off. Let's see if next week he does 1 million copies. If he goes double platinum in 2 weeks, then I'll recant my statement. But I am here to tell you this is a mediocre album, and the only reason that we're even discussing this is because of Jay-Z and because of the five talking points, because everyone on YouTube to Twitter to Facebook to everyone is quoting them same five lines that you and your wife just quoted. Oh, he said, I'm giving you $1 million a game for 99 cents. He said his mom was gay. He said, I'm sorry to Beyonce. These were all the things that you expected him to say. It's just like, he went into a war room and put a bullet in the board up and said, let me make a bullet point of all these things that I have to say. And he's touched on all those things because those were the things that you wanted him to say on this album. That if they were missing from this album, you would feel the same way I feel about the album. I just feel like this album is just a gloss over to sell whatever the fuck he's selling now. But that's just my personal opinion.
So, but you are a Kendrick Lamar fan. You like his latest album. You said that, right?
Oh, yeah. That's my favorite Kendrick Lamar album. And to be honest, like, you say I'm a hater, but I was not a real Kendrick Lamar fan. I thought he was dope. I thought he had good lyrics. But, you know, the first two albums, they were just three. Was it two? Three? Yeah, it's two albums. It was just, they were okay to me. Like, I liked some songs, but they weren't, like, when I say albums, I mean, I just put the album on and I don't have to turn it off. Like Illmatic, like Blueprint 1 and, you know, like the real Blueprint with Boogie Down Productions. Stuff like that where you just put the album on. You don't have to fast forward. You got the skit, everything you like. So that's just me, though.
All right. On to another song, man.
Now greetings to the world. Gangsta no live in a tenement yard. No. Hood boy no live in a tenement yard. Too much watchy. Too much so. Our them chatty.
Fuck all this pretty Sean Carter shit, nigga. Ho. Sean was on that gospel shit. I was on the total fucking opposite shit. Stuff $1 million in a sock drawer. That's a war chest in case you need your chest knocked off. Y'all be talking crazy under the IG pictures. So when you get the hell, you tell them Blanco sent you. I can't take no threats, I got a set of twins. Those were just some words you never hear again. For the final time, you don't believe these fools. I never seen a worker rock so many jewels. Ever. I never seen a runner with so many cars. Ever. Y'all couldn't stop me, you're not as tough as you say you are. My advice is just don't be too nice to niggas. Just set the price so niggas to live your life, my nigga. Once upon a time in the projects, Sean was in flight mode, I bought a Pyrex. I was in fight mode, oh now it's fuck me, mijo. I was moving them kilos, help you move your peoples. Sometimes you need your ego, gotta remind you.
All right. So that's him. That I believe that song right there established his credibility. Like, yo, I'm changing my image, but I once was here, you know what I'm saying? But I can't be there no more. But I used to do these rocks, and I used to do, you know, sell these up in Marcy Projects, and I used to do this, and I used to do that. But now I got a set of twins, so I'm going to be here. I ain't going back to that life. That's pretty much what he was saying on that. You sighing real hard.
I'm like Vern, man. Vern said, I've reached my limit of things to talk about this. I can't express anything else about it, Keith. I don't know what else I can say. I mean, out of all the songs, though, that is my favorite one though, on the album.
This shit went hard, right?
Yeah, it's a nice song.
I think because you're a producer, you ain't fucking with no ID's production on here.
No, I think that, like I said, I think it's well produced. The lyrics are dope, but it sounds, you know what it is? It sounds more like he's a spoken word album. Like, he's not flowing. Like, I'm used to Jay-Z flowing and like with the lyrics, but flowing over the tracks. This is more just like a spoken word album. Like, he could have took all the music away and just spoke on the album. It had some bongos in the back. He might as well went all the way black to the black. You know what I'm saying? It sound like what's the shit with Neil Long? What's the movie? Love Jones. This is Love Jones Part 2 album. This is the soundtrack they about to put Love Jones 2 out. Cause yeah. That's what this sounds like. That's all I'm saying. It's good for hip hop. It's a good thing to have a positive message. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, RC said he was sampling that Main Source. Main Source just hanging out. They actually use that from the reggae song. That
yeah, that's from
that's a reggae song. Boom, man, boom. Dude. I can't remember her name, but it's a female that did that first. So Main exactly. Source took that beat. I mean, really, yeah. Rob made me laugh, and Rob ain't hating too. Hating on Joe Camel. You in here with your G pom poms on in here, man. You know what I'm saying? You in here with your G pom pom. I know me, you, and him represent Bad News. Stuart Gardens, we was down there at the young age of 3 years old. Me, you, and Rob. So we come up from a long time, even in junior high together.
But, and Tiffany said, I want Jay-Z to talk about the kitchen. No, I don't want Jay-Z to talk about the kitchen. All I'm saying is, how do you go from talking about the kitchen, just your last album, to now being super conscious, man? Like, I could see if this was a gradual trend, but for 20 years, Jay-Z has let us know just the type of person he is. I'm a billionaire now, but I ain't left the streets. I'm still down with the streets, and I can still do that shit with the best. Like, he said that on one, I don't know which album, where he just said, and you can drop me in the middle of something in the Arctic broke, and I bet you I'll get rich. So that he's a hustler, and I understand that. There's no problem with that. All I'm saying is, you can't earn a stripe for being conscious at your first effort, and then your effort is just a mediocre presentation.
Wow,
Beth.
Now Grego normally is on your side. He normally is. He's usually a fan of the millennials, a fan of Uzi. Kodak Black, all that stuff. Grego had just popped up in here and said Jay-Z album was magnificent.
You're right, but wasn't Grego the one that said that his favorite rapper was who the hell he said his favorite rapper was?
Well, I know who he don't like, KRS-One. I don't know who his favorite.
That's Grego. He the one that said he don't like KRS-One. So nah, I don't want Grego to be on my side this time. Oh, he's not. Yeah, because he said the album is magnificent. Well, you know, everybody's entitled to their opinion. I want to know what Jersey Vern thinks. Because I didn't see what he thought about the album.
No, you don't. Because my phone will be ringing next, man. You know.
Oh, I can't wait.